Look, I've done all I'm gonna do. Swallowed that rotten gunk sister gave me. I've been throwing up for an hour. Look, Sandy, just leave me alone.
It was worth it, you'll see.
But I feel terrible. Couldn't even eat my lunch.
Where's your sense of adventure? We put one over on the screws, didn't we?
How do you figure that? The whole thing was a stuffer. We didn't get a thing out of it.
You've got to learn to trust your Auntie Sandy.
What are you doing?
Take a look.
Cunning bugger. I'd never thought of looking there.
Neither did they. I told you I'd get them, didn't I?
Oh, yeah, but when they said you had to be strict and everything, I thought you'd miss out.
Barry's an amateur.
Struth. What are you going to do with them? Sell them?
Drugs are for fools and pushers are worse. Remember that.
Sorry, I wasn't thinking. Who are they for, then?
Bea Smith. She really needs them.
Bea? What are you going to give them to Bea for?
What kind of question's that? You've known Bea for years. Do you want to see her in pain?
That's not the point. She's not top dog anymore. You are. Top dogs don't go around helping one another.
That's just where you're wrong. As long as they're on the level with me, I'll always play straight and fair by them. Feeling crook?
I felt better. Why?
You weren't at breakfast.
Yeah, it's because I wasn't hungry.
Won't the sister give you anything?
A couple of lousy aspirin. What will they do?
These might help.
I'm not into drugs. And you had better remember that.
They're not drugs, they're painkillers.
Yeah? And what's the difference?
May I see them? Where did you get these?
What is it?
Pethidine.
It's what you said she needed.
Well, I didn't tell you to steal them.
How else was I supposed to get them?
Look, would these help?
Yes, they'd ease the pain, but you'd have to be careful how many you took. No more than one in the morning and one in the afternoon. I'll get you some water.
Trouble, eh?
Yeah, university education to operate one of these things. If I was on the outside, I'd be getting a 6-month instruction course.
Well, it wouldn't help you feeling sick.
Oh, don't you start. I'm getting enough from that stupid cow I share a cell with.
She's a doctor, Bea.
Well, not a very good one if she ended up in here.
She'd know if you were sick.
I know I'm sick.
Then why don't you do something about it? Find out what it is. You promised you would.
I know what it is.
How can you?
Because my mother had it. It's a brain tumor. Now, are you satisfied?
Come on, Bea. You can't get that kind of thing from your parents. Can you?
But you can from a bash on the head. I saw it happen to my mother. Headaches and dizziness. Feeling sick. And she ended up a bloody vegetable.
But, Bea, that doesn't mean that you're going to.
The paddy wagon, remember? I was knocked so bloody stupid I couldn't even remember who I was for days.
Well, you could still be wrong.
Yeah, but what if I'm right? My mother couldn't even feed herself. Couldn't wash or dress or anything. Yeah, sometimes I was sure she knew what was going on. She couldn't say anything. She couldn't make anyone understand. Well, I'm not going to have that happening to me. I'd rather die.
Bea, I think maybe you ought to go and have those tests, you know, just to know what you're facing.
I know what I'm facing.
What's going on here? This is the second time I've had to speak to you this morning, Bryant. You're supposed to be in reception, not hanging around with Smith causing trouble.
We're not causing trouble.
Well, what were you doing?
Just talking.
About what?
It's personal.
I didn't ask you. Well? You're on a charge, Bryant. A dumb insolence. Now get back to reception. Get on with it, Smith. Unless you'd rather go back to the laundry.
Mrs. Morris. Would you keep an eye on that?
Right. Peterson?
Sit down, Kate. You share a cell with B. Smith?
Yes.
There are rumors that she is ill. What do you know about that?
Have you asked her?
Not yet.
Then I don't think I should say anything.
You seem to have picked up the prisoner's code of silence very quickly.
It's got nothing to do with that. It's medical ethics. I don't think I should discuss anybody's medical condition without their knowledge.
If Smith is ill and she won't admit it, don't you think it's important that she should receive the proper medical attention? All right, then. If you were her doctor, what treatment would you prescribe?
I'd have to do tests first, renal tests.
Then you do think there is something wrong with Smith?
Yes.
And you know what it is?
Well, without the tests, I'd only be guessing.
If your guess were correct, and she didn't receive the proper medical attention, what would happen then?
She'd die. Quite soon.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again.